Huh. There's actually nothing here. Oh, hello. Okay, is that a Poe? I don't have the resources to handle you. Actually, no, I have a throwing spear, I guess. No, that was too far. Let's go grab that. Apparently, I'm fighting a Poe now. Where's my spear? There it is. Grab this. Threw it way too far. Hey, buddy. Duh. Ooh. What are you summoning? The forces of everything? Okay, come on. Come on out. Come on out. Come on out. Got him. Wait. That is not it. Come on. Hit him. Yeah. That was some good damage there. He's down to almost half HP. What will I get out of this, honestly? Okay, come on out. Got him! Oh, wait. Broadsword. And can I kill him the rest of the way? Yes! That wasn't too difficult. A lightning rod. Magical rod that can shoot balls of energy. Its gem contains lightning from the Hyrule Hills. It's not recommended to use as a melee weapon. Neat! Where's my boomerang? Because that was really useful. That was a great weapon to have. Lightning rod. How do I use this? Woo! Okay. We have a lightning rod, but I'm going to stick to the spear for now because that's pretty useful. Those Lizalfos weapons were great. Okay. Where's Heart? Heart, buddy. There you are. Anyway, hey guys and gals, I'm Pal, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. When we last left off, I was right over that hill. We got a shrine knocked out of the way. We're currently in this area of the map, above Nekluda? Nekluda. We left Kakariko Village. We honestly were kind of all over the place last episode, but this time I have a vague direction of where I need to be going, and that it is that way towards that tower. But I also saw this shrine over there, which I would like to knock out pretty quickly, because shrines are awesome to get. I'm also going to defeat any Lizalfos in the way, because... Good job, Heart! I didn't know you could help me fight. Heart, buddy! Buddy, that's fine. I don't want you to get hurt. And die! Grab your other spear. You don't hurt my horse. Heart is mine. Cool. Good boy, Heart. You're awesome. He hit him twice. Good job, buddy. I just don't want you to die. But yeah, like as I was saying, the shrines are awesome to get because they lead to stat increases. Let's avoid those longhorns because I'm pretty sure they could just kill me and Heart. So... I would really like to get those upgrades, if I can. This is a camp, but honestly, I don't really care. It's just Bokoblins. I don't need to face Bokoblins. So let's go- What? Oh, you there! What on earth? Didn't expect that. Who's talking also? Over here! I'm over here! Is that a- Zora? Hello? I apologize for calling on you so suddenly. I am Leto, a proud member of the distinguished Zora. As you are a real Hylian, I had no choice but to call upon you. Will you please spare me a moment of your time? Sure. Thing? Thank you so very much. Do you see that tower, the one atop the mountain yonder? Yeah, I'm heading there. I need you to go upstream of Zora River, which runs along the north side of that tower, to Inago Bridge. I can see it in your eyes. You're asking yourself, why me? A reasonable question for a stranger accosted by passing Zora in such a manner. But I must assure you, this venture will be very profitable for you as well. You see, Prince Sidon of the Zora is in desperate search of a strong Hylian. As this is a royal request from the prince himself, it's safe to assume a generous reward is in the cards. That is why I'm asking you to meet with Prince Sidon at Inago Bridge, along with the Zora River just upstream of here. I can do that. Yeah, I can do that. Man, the Zora are very cordial people. I am a fan. So I guess this is the realm of the Zoras. Also, this is a mistake. That was kind of lame. Especially after he's like, "You are of a strong personality. I need you to save my people." And then the guy he talks to promptly climbs a tower and then drowns himself. That was kind of dumb. Also, I don't even know if I can get in there. Because there are barbs everywhere. Maybe I can blow it up. That's always an option. Can't blow it up. How am I supposed to get in there? A Chigaloo tree nut, which I can use for recipes. Yeah, I don't think I can get in there, guys. Yeah, that hurts a little bit. Okay. Well, I guess I'm not going there. Okay. Back on the road. We have our direction from the Zora. It was really fortunate that I just happened to go there, because otherwise I would not have. I can't cross this, or can I? No, I can. It's shallow. It's kind of hard to tell, but it's shallow enough. So I can cross the water and head towards that tower, which is where I was going to go anyway. But this time, I need to keep on the lookout for a bridge. And that bridge will hopefully have a bunch of Zoras in it and not some trap set up for poor travelers by. Honestly, the Zora seemed... Whoa! Hello. It's a village. A kind of weird-looking village. Can I actually... Yeah, I know, buddy. It's kind of hard. Can you get down this? It's kind of steep for you. Sorry, I don't mean to do this to you. No, you're good. Okay. But what is this? Looks kind of scary, to be honest. Oh, actually, no, not even scary. It looks like something from... Oh, this is an enemy. Oh, this is an enemy area. All right. I was gonna say, it looks like something from Spirit Tracks, but no, this is indeed an enemy place. Let's re-equip a weapon here. I have another spear, cool. Is there a boss for this place that I can talk to and sort things out? Honestly, it looks very organized. Here, Heart, could you get over here? I kinda need you, just in case I need to make a run for it. Okay, I can go that way. Heart, wait, no, Heart, wait. No, don't you hurt my horse. Are you hurting my horse? What was that? What were you just doing? Like, what was that? Here, real quick, I'll end your miserable game. And get another Bokobo if I can drop one of my old wooden bows. Yeah, I can drop that. There, I got a Bokobo. Heart, come on. Need you to come this way. This is kind of odd. It looks like it should be a bigger area because, like, there's a giant fish skull. There's a bunch of scary things. It looks like it should be some huge, gigantic fortress. Are all the Zoras going to be talking to me? Yeah, I know. Your prince needs me. I just talked to what's-his-face across the river there. Across the river Kwai. Oh my, oh wow, oh whoa! It's a Hylian, a real Hylian! I mean, you're Hylian, right? Yes, I am indeed a Hylian. I knew it, I so knew it! Well, what are you waiting for? Go see Prince Sidon! Where is he? He's waiting at Inago Bridge, which is upstream of Zora River. Please listen to what dear Prince Sidon has to say. I know it's sudden, but you'll understand everything once you get there. Trust me, you'll see. Yeah, this seems a bit too elaborate to be a trap. I mean, unless it's an elaborate trap, then all bets are off. But it doesn't seem like a trap with all these people saying, "Hey, you should go here," and them all being really friendly. So I'm heading upstream. I'm heading the wrong way, actually. Need to pull a quick 180. Come on, heart. You can walk around a tree. Okay, so I'm heading this way now. Come on, buddy. I know bridges are a bit scary for horses, but you're just gonna have to deal with it. Pull a sharp turn. Run past that bokoblin. This looks very ominous. I need to climb this bridge, actually. Ooh! No, 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 no. I really wish I had arrows, because I'm trying to go with a stealthy build here. And it doesn't entirely work out. When I can't shoot them. Alright, I lost that weapon. On to this one. I didn't mean to whistle him. Buddy, don't come in here. Don't come in here. This is not the kind of fight you want. Don't fight. Don't hit my horse. Don't hit my horse. No. Don't kill Heart. Come on, Heart, fight back. Come on. It's no fair to fight a guy and his horse, or just a horse. Let's eat some food. There we go. No, no, kill this, kill this. Kill the head. Heart, you're fine, right? Oh, he's fine. Good. Okay, I got the head. Alright, Heart, are you fine? Okay, good, and I got some arrows out of that. But ultimately, what I want to do is climb. I need to go to the thing upstream, right? Yes. But also, I would like to take care of this tower first, and then from there, I have license to glide down, which would be useful. What has 240 HP? Hello. Do I want to fight that? I do. I honestly do. Come on. Kill him. My claymore broke, but he's almost dead. Switch over to the Lizal boomerang. Oh, okay, ow. I tried to jump. I tried to buffer a jump, but I was mid-animation, and it did not work. Well, I tried. Jump attack! Yeah, that did a lot of damage. Knock him back down. Blow him up! I don't have any arrows, I don't have any arrows. Oh, knock him down. Oh, I got his weapon! Spiked Moblin Club. Animal bone has been affixed to this Moblin Cub to greatly improve its damage. Well, he should be fairly harmless from here on out. In fact, harmless enough to kill with one last attack. Neat. Got a cool weapon. And actually, I can loot this real quick. Maybe? Usually I can loot these. No, I guess not. Alright, so what was I doing? I was climbing this. It's a ram. Please don't harm me, Mr. Ram. I won't harm you back if you don't harm me. Okay, tower. Up at the top of this. It's not, that's a shroom up there. I thought it was an enemy. Whoa! Little sinkholes. That's odd and new. Some meat. Guy with a bow. Some fruit. Okay. Cool. If I can ignore this guy, then I will. And it looks like I can. Let's jump down here. Restore my stamina so I can climb back up. Oi! There. Alright, where am I going? I'm right at the foothills of this. Don't even need to really plan my climb because there are ledges literally everywhere. I can reach the top here pretty easily. Oh, maybe not. Maybe not so easily. There, I'm good. Ooh, that was close. Let's just drop this. Get some more, maybe? No, I guess not. Alright. At the very base, hopefully there are no enemies waiting for us up here. Looks like there aren't. Linear Tower, awesome. Good stuff. This should be a fairly easy climb, actually. There are no barbs to get in our way. Yeah, this will be a really easy climb. Cool. Maybe not so easy. Oh, boy. Just one more jump diagonally. Okay, good. Whew. That was close, so I guess I can't do that. Let's climb it up normally. Very nice. Very cool. It, with all of the vistas we've been seeing, I would kind of like, if I were emulating this, I'd love to emulate this. I could do like a thing where I compare the inputs. So I basically mirror the inputs and save a log of them and then simultaneously show how good the Switch looks as opposed to this, but it'd be kind of cool because I haven't, like I said, I haven't watched Zelda, so I don't know exactly how, I don't know exactly how much better Zelda for the Switch looks as opposed to this, but I assume that it does look better. There's a Po down there, which those seem to be fairly easy sources of those electric rods, although the problem is that they're kind of a hound for weapon durability. Like, things with high HP, you have to look and see, is it worth it to fight that thing? Because I'm going to lose at least two or three weapons in doing so. And with not a great source of finding weapons, at least not yet. Like, look at my weapons here. I have a broken soldier's claymore, a woodcutter's axe, and then these. These are not that great. Oopsie. So you have to ask yourself how, if it's actually worth it. Okay, we're to the top of the tower. Let's distill that rune and then head towards the bridge that the Zora have mentioned and then end off the episode there. Sheikah Tower activated. And this appears to be the Laneru region, which makes sense because there is an ocean nearby and there was a Laneru Sea in Skyward Sword. And also, Nehru is the, you know, it's like the ocean goddess. She's blue and stuff. So this makes sense. Let's get that rune, fill out our gamepad here. Get some of the names of the things in this area. Regional map extracted. Very nice. So where are we actually heading, though, with the whole Zora thing? We're heading upriver, they said, across a bridge. So where am I gliding? Oh, whoa, whoa, wait, what? When did you get here? Wow, I can't believe it. Excuse me. Yes, you. I am Groove of the Zora. It is apparent that you are a traveler, but may I ask what brought you here? I could really ask the same. How very astute of you. An excellent query indeed. I, by order of Prince Sidon of the Zora's domain, am searching for a Hylian. Or I was, but then I fell asleep. I woke to a loud noise and awful waking, and now here I am. I'd like to get down and be on my way, but I'm simply too high up. I need to figure something out. Prince Sidon is down by the bridge below, but for some reason I cannot seem to catch his attention. But you are a Hylian, yes? Well then, my luck is improving. Prince Sidon, I found one! I found a Hylian! Prince Sidon doesn't seem to notice my struggle. Perhaps I should swallow my fear and jump to the river below. Then I could return to him. He must be word sick. Nope, can't do it. I'm too high up. I'm likely to meet the gods of the ever after before I reach Prince Sidon again. Mr. Hylian, I must apologize. It will be some time before I can get back to Prince Sidon. Please, you must leave me here and go on ahead. Down there, you said? I can do that. Plus, it's near the shrine that I wanted to go to anyway. So, all the way down here, huh? Oh. Ooh. That's pretty. Okay, well, I'll go to the shrine first, because you guys know I'm addicted to the shrines. I love them shrines. Hello. A Hylian. Oh my, how wonderful. You are a Hylian, yes? Perfect. It must be my lucky day. I apologize for calling out to you so suddenly. I am Turfo of the Zora. I have been searching for a hireling like you for a very long time. My home, Zora's domain, is in terrible danger. That is why Prince Sidon sent me to search for a strong Hylian warrior. Prince Sidon is waiting at a no-go bridge. Would you please go to the prince and perhaps save us all? We would be ever so grateful. Yeah, I can do that just as soon as I get this plant. A big hearty radish. And also, go in the shrine. A minor test of strength. See, this is one I can get behind. We've done the major tests of strength and the mediocre, or the moderate test of strength, but minor tests of strength is just my speed. Okay, it's a little guy. Okay, I have 325, and now I can see HP bars, which is nice. So I fought one of these before. My strategy is pretty much the same. I would like to shield bash his long attack. There it is. They all follow the same pattern. Come at me, bro. That did not work. That's fine. I can still do that. Weapon? Let's just get rid of this woodcutter's axe. And not whistle heart. Oh, hello. Link didn't draw his shield in time. Nope. It's not what I want. Come on. Come on, buddy. Get a couple hits on him. Alright, this is what I want. There we go. And get a couple good, really good attacks on him. Nice. But his HP is really high. I don't have any arrows. Okay, come on, buddy. There he goes. Nice! Hit him! Yeah! Alright, switch over to Lizelle Boomerang. And does this actually deal damage to him if he tries to do the long spinny attack at me through a pillar? That'd be great. Let's find out. Come on, buddy. Yes, it does! Okay, so that's an easy way to deal damage to him. He's already down by a third. Much better than the previous trials. Okay, come on. Come on, buddy. Come get this pillar. Get up in this pillar. Spin at me. Nice. Okay. He's down to half HP. What is this attack? What is this attack? Whoa! Can I? Woo! Yeah! That was cool! And my boomerang's down. Hopefully I get some weapons out of this. Because I'm running low. Let's try this lightning rod. Okay. He's gonna do it again. And I missed! Oh, and I missed! I missed! I missed! I missed! Oh boy! I missed him! That did nothing. Okay. Whoa! Let's switch to a weapon that's a little bit more my speed. Why are you whistling, Link? I'm not doing down on the D-pad at all. Do I still have a shield? Yeah, I do. Okay. He's going to do that. And I can hit him. Deal a ton of damage. And finish him off. Yes! Cool. Guardian Sword. And a Guardian Shield, and a ton of ancient parts. Guardian Shield, a shield made with ancient Sheikah technology. It can deflect a Guardian Scout's beam. I can't carry any more shields. And gets a bunch of ancient parts. And I think that's enough ancient screws that I can use them to get an upgrade for one of my runes, which will be pretty neat. Alright, a Knight's Bow. Not bad, not bad. I do want to use the stealth bow, but I have a knight's bow now, I guess. Let's throw away some traveler's bows. And that's it. Cool. I can get behind that. And then get our spirit orb. Which one is this, actually? Is it number three? I think it's number three. It might be number four, honestly. We've gotten enough shrines at this point. It may be number four. Spirit orb number three. Okay. All right, before we end off the episode, let's go to the bridge, because all of the Zora have been talking about this, and I'm interested to see the Zora prints. And find out why he wants a Hylian so bad. Young one.
Up top, above you.
That's the prince.
Pardon the entrance, but you are Hylian, aren't you? I was hoping perhaps you'd have a moment to talk.
Ha, Hylian, yes, I knew it. Oh, pardon me. I am Sidon, the Zora Prince. And what is your name? Go on, please tell me. Link. Your name is Link? What a fantastic name! Though I cannot shake the feeling that I've heard it somewhere before. Well, in any case, it is a strong name. To be honest, I've been watching you. I've seen the way you work. I can tell by how you carry yourself that you are no ordinary person. Link, you must be a strong warrior among the Hylians, correct? Yeah, I would say that I am. Aha, just as I suspected. I am a Zora prince, after all. I have an eye for talent that is unparalleled. Yes, exquisite. I have been have been searching for someone like you for a long while. A man like you, Link, who carries himself with power. Right now, Zora's domain is in grave danger because of a massive rainfall coming from divine beast Varuta. Please, promise you will help us. We need your strength, warrior. Won't you come to Zora's domain with me? Yeah, I'll do that. Wow, really? Thank you, Link. You are indeed the man I thought you were. Now, Zora's domain will be saved for certain. No time to waste. Hurry up and head over. Because of the rain, the cliffs are wet to climb. To reach the domain, you will need to go straight along this path. As a Hylian, I know you are unable to swim up the river. As such, the path to the domain may be a bit treacherous. You likely have a tough fight in store. There are monsters up ahead that attack with electricity. Don't give up, I believe in you. Oh, that's right. I have something I would like to give you. This is just a small trinket to show that I have faith in you. Electro Elixir grants a mid-level resistance to electricity, useful against enemies with electrical attacks. It is a drink that will increase your resistance to electricity. I'm not sure why, but its effects do not seem to work for Zora. Perhaps because it was made specifically for Hylians. It should do wonders for you, though. I shall go ahead and make sure there is not anything strange going on where you are headed. I'm counting on you. Alright! We have a mission! And a very flamboyant Zora. It's nice to actually see a Zora with personality. Like, the last time we saw that was Rudo, I believe, in Ocarina of Time, and she was just feisty, and she complained all the time, that's it. So now we have something to do. Hey, buddy. I have this. This deals so much. That two-shot him. That's insane. Get some arrows out of it. What are you doing? What was that? What do you call that maneuver? Okay, but that is actually going to be it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode in any capacity, please click like. If you didn't, then drop a comment telling me I could make the next episode so that you would like it. I release new episodes of Breath of the Wild every Monday and Wednesday. I'm also playing Pikmin right now. What are you doing? Go away. I'm also playing Pikmin right now. And I release new episodes of that every Tuesday and Thursday. And join me next time for another Breath of the Wild, where hopefully I'll stop being hit by stupids. Go away, Octorok. I'm trying to do an end slate. Go. Will. Purples, when thrown at his feet, will harm him. I have never killed a beady longlegs that way. I read about it online, and I wanted to see it for myself. That's sad. In the Japanese version, you can actually... So I want them. Whoa! Those are like the arrows in the trailer. Come on. Okay! Ow! Game over. You bet game over if I get hit by that.